Everyday Glory.
I'm joined here by Grey Lady Dan, who are going to tell us a little bit about their history and what they're going to do tonight. Mark, if you could kick off, when did you get together?
The band historically was Martin, Julian and Louis, who had been masquerading around the Oxford area under the name Shadowland, nothing to do with Clive Nolan's outfit, I hasten to add. Parted company, I believe, with their rhythm section about 3 years ago, when myself and Sean, who'd been working together previously in another band, happened to see this little advert and walked into their wonderful world.
You all joined up together. And this is your first CD anyway.
It is.
Isn't it, The Crime? Is that sort of based on any concept at all, or is it just a collection of songs put together?
Best ask the man who writes the lyrics.
remarkable.
Oh, yeah.
No, not really. It was just a couple of songs that were in there. The Fugitive and The Ballad of Billy Gray, which is one's about an escaped prisoner, the other one's about a serial killer. So we thought there were a couple of good crime
bits. Lots of homely
so
topics.
We thought it would be a good title for the album.
Yeah. As a serial killer, as in sort of shredded wheat. And
that's right.
That's right.
He could eat three.
The breakfast
Cheerios boxes.
Actually, it's just a vacant intellectual void into which pretension was poured liberally, and we came out at the other end of the mixer.
No, really what it was. We just prayed that the NME would review it so they could say, this album is a crime, enough said.
And have they.
We know they've got a copy, but I don't think they've reviewed it.
I mean, we do like to shock the system. We go on telly and show them train spotting numbers, and that really winds them up.
And tonight we'll all be wearing anoraks.
Yes, I was going to say, what about your fans? Are they going to be coming in anoraks? leather anoraks.
This has become more and more of a joke recently.
Actually, most of them drive small Fiestas, but they wear anoraks within them, and so they arrive in the Fiesta. Then they carry the anorak in. It's like a life support system. They actually have a few salient numbers, train numbers, sellotaped inside, just in case they feel like they're deflated at all in any way. You know, looking like, oh, life's okay, I've got my class 47 double header.
Can I actually join in on the scene?
You've blown my cover, you sod.
Ah, right. How are you doing, Chris? Fine. Yep. Have you got your set sorted out for tonight?
It might be lurking in my pocket.
Just sort of make it up. To go along.
No, I'd rather give you definitive facts and then play something completely different later on.
Yes, this is another one that we have written.
This will throw you. It's all right, Martin always gets them in the wrong order anyway. Tonight, what are we playing tonight? It says here we will be doing The Ballad of Billy Gray.
Well, hang on. Just about to go in. Tell me when you're ready, young man. Oh, he's still rolling. This, hey, you should have finished by now.
This is live TV.
Hey, personal problem.
Go on, pass it over and stop mucking around.
No more. Right, so what are you going to do tonight? Are you going to do the whole of The Crime and some new stuff?
Or? Some new, some old. One of the epics off The Crime. Three other numbers off the album.
Are we not doing The Crime then?
Oh, you've got to
no, we're not tonight. We haven't got time.
You're not
That's
doing the
problem.
Crime.
Not the whole.
Well,
of it.
No, we've
got it.
No, what we've done is we've annexed a couple of the long songs from the album, so it's 30 minutes. Everyone thinks, God, they're really clever. They got a 30-minute song, but actually we haven't. We've just got about 31-minute songs because you can't write a long piece of music. We just sellotape
so
the buggers together.
It's the same when we write songs. We write 3 3-minute songs and just glue the buggers together and end up with a 9-minute epic.
Well,
isn't that cunning?
In fact, you started off for Eurovision, and in fact, you got dropped because you've got all these.
Well, that's true.
They dropped us because the songs were too short and accessible. Strange.
We used to have a Swedish girl singer too, with
Oh, that is a shame.
I don't want to talk about that too.
But then we got him, who's got an enormous nose.
Instead of an enormous pair of lungs.
You're dead.
Well, you've got to do a sound check. Hopefully you'll get that done before you kick off. Thanks very much.
No problem at all.
Cheers.
Thank you.
Bye. Now it's...
Good evening. Welcome to sunny Rotherham. I'd like to introduce a new band to us, first time we've been here to Rotherham, having heard the album which is on sale afterwards, I'm sure it won't be the first time they ever come, or the last. Please welcome Grey Lady Dan.
Thank you.
Thank you. Mr. You never ran earlier on, but there you go. This is a song called I Believe. We'll be right back. I'm going to carry on with a very new one. This is, it's a song about love. A lot of kind of gubbins. It's a song called Guilt. Thank you. I'm gonna run over the segue. This is gonna quiet the little mood down a little. This is features your man over here on guitar. This is a thing called The Thrill of It All. Thank you. song all about a pilot. It's a song called Flyer. Thank you. freshly pressed today, if you like. Right, we're gonna do a song that some of you may or may not know, but most of you'll know this. If you're not, this is a silly bit. And it fits in.
Thank you.
you very much. It's been a long drive today, but I tell you what, it's been goddamn worth it.
Good to be home, lads. Good to be home.
Bye, golly. Anyway, this is something you'll know. We thought we'd finish off on this. This is we've got a damn nerve to do this. This is Supper's Rip. No, it's not. Grendel? This is Grand Night's Night. This is Run Like Hell.